We are not going to discuss the circuit for division as it is out of the scope of this syllabus. And we have come to an end of the discussion of arithmetic operation that is available with ALU. The logical operations in ALU is realized by the logical gates, and the relational operation is realized by the magnitude comparator. What is a magnitude comparator? We are given two numbers A and B, and we are supposed to generate the output for these questions. Is A is greater than B, or is A less than B, or A is equal to B? With the results of these three fundamental operations, we can derive the result of other operations. Like if A is greater than or equal to B, in that case, either this condition A greater than or equal to B has to be true, or A should be equal to B. Either this result or this result has to be 1, and we can pass it to an OR gate and get the result. Similarly, if we wanted to find whether A is less than or equal to B, either this or this will be true. So we can pass the result of these two operations and get the final result of if A is less than or equal to B. Let's assume, for example, we have two numbers with A equal to 99 and B equal to 100. Now suppose we are asked to find out whether A is greater than B, or B is greater than A, or A is equal to B. We will be able to directly say the answer that B is greater than A. Okay. How can we conclude this? Here B is 3 digits long and A has only 2 digits. That means that B is greater than A. Can we have this principle in computers to find out whether a number is greater than or equal to the other number? No, because for storing each of the number, we are going to use a fixed size memory locations called registers. So the number of digits or the number of bits will be same. Okay, so we will have something like this. A is 099 and B is 100, which is 100, and this is 99. So in this case, I cannot rely on the number of digits to differentiate one number from the other. Now, given that the number of digits are going to be same, unlike other operations which we start from the least significant bit, for comparison, okay, we start from the most significant bit. See, if we start from the least significant bit, we will compare 9 and 0 and decide that this A is greater, and again 9 and 0, A is greater. And then finally, we have to say that a 0 is less than 1 and therefore B is greater. Okay, so we don't do this. Okay, this is a longer process. Instead, we start from the most significant bit and find out that 0 is less than B, which is having 1 in its most significant bit, and therefore B is greater. We can decide it directly. So let's see how we can do this in binary numbers. So let's assume two binary numbers which are 4 bit long. A, which is having 4 bits from A0 to A3, and similarly B having 4 bits B0 to B3. Now when can we claim that A is equal to B? A3 has to be equal to B3, A2 has to be equal to B2, and B1 has to be equal to A1, and finally A0 has to be equal to B0. In general, we can say if we have n bit numbers, all my bits AI has to be equal to BI for all I that ranges from 0 to 3, in this case in general 0 to n. And this AI can be either 0 or 1. Similarly, BI can be either 0 or 1. And when both of them are equal in all respective bit positions, we can claim that A is equal to B. So when A is equal to B, then both AI and BI in a bid position are going to be same. That is, either both of them is equal to 0 or both of them are equal to 1. So we can define a variable xi such that we get the AND of ai bi. So if both of them are 1, this bit is going to be 1. If both of them are going to 0, we can compute ai bar bi bar. In that case, this bit will be 1. And when we make a OR of this, when both are 1, this is going to be 1. When both are 0, this bit is going to be 1. So when ai and bi both are equal, this entire operation ai bi or ai bar bi bar will be equal to 1. That is, xi will be equal to 1. And we can define the operation a equal to b like this. When x3 is 1, x2 is 1, x1 is 1, x0 is 1, when all the x's are 1, then we can claim that a is equal to b. There was an extra x3 here, I striked it out. Okay, so just we can pass all the result of xi's to AND gate, and if the result of AND gate is 1, then we can say that A is equal to B. When can we claim that A is greater than B? In that case, say for example A3 will be 1 and say B3 is 0, then we can claim that A is greater than B. Okay, so I can say A3 B3 bar, because B3 is 0. So we will have A3 B3 bar if the most significant bit is different. But suppose if both of them are same, say for example both of them are 0, then this will be 0. And we know that x3 will be 1 then. So I can make use of this, and since we are unable to decide based on the most significant bit, we will pass to the next most significant bit, which is A2 B2. Now if A2 is 1 and B2 is 0, then we can claim that A is greater than B. Okay, so we have to ensure that the most significant bit was same, like A3 is equal to B3 and A2 is 1 and B2 is 0. So we compute A2 B2 bar. And if these two bits are also same, okay, say both of them are 0 or both of them are 1, then we have to rely on the next bit, which is A1 B1. So in that case, both the most significant bits, okay, A3 and A2, are equal to B3 B2. So we have X3 X2 to be 1, and we have to compare the bits in the bit position 1. So we have A1 into B1 bar. If these two bits were also same, then we have to finally compare the least significant bit, which is A0 and B0. In that case, A3 to A1 will be equal to B3 to B1, and therefore X3, X2, X1 will be 1. And finally, if A2 is 1 and B2 is 0, then we can claim that A is greater than B. And we can compute A less than B in a very similar manner. In that case, A3 will be 0, B3 is 1. In that case, we can claim that B is greater. So we have A3 bar B3. And if A3 and B3 are same, we have X3 to be 1. And we can find whether if A2 is 0 and B2 is 1 and so on. We can proceed in this way and we can find out whether A is less than B. To implement these equations, that is, we have to find out Xi and we have to find out this equation and we have to implement these partial products, and finally we have to implement the equations for A greater than B and a less than b as well. Okay, so to generate the equations of a greater than b, we have to multiply a3 with b3 bar, and similarly for a less than b, we have a3 bar into b3 and so on, right? And to generate this xi, okay, since we are generating this one, a3 b3 bar and a3 b3 bar, we can exploit this and generate this xi. Okay, how we can do that? We can multiply to generate this one ai. I can multiply ai and I can do this one ai bi bar, which we are generating here already, and ai bar into bi. We can make a r of this and make a complement of this, okay, using de Morgan's law. If we do this, we will get this one, right? So we are going to exploit this to generate the circuit. Here we generate a3 bar into b3, here we generate a3 into b3 bar, and we can pass it to the NOR gate. So we add it and make a complement of this, okay, and this will generate x3. Similar setup we have for x2, x1 and x0, and this term is actually a3 bar into b3, right? So this term will be passed on to the AND gate. So this will be a less than b, because a3 bar b3, so b3 should be 1 and a3 bar should be 1, so a3 should be 0. So this is the equation for a less than b, and we can combine all these things to this OR gate, and we have the AND of all x's together. X3, we have x3 here, x2 here, x1 and x0, all of them goes here, and we generate the output of a equal to b. And this AND gate ensures that the most significant bit is same, that is x3, and we have a2 bar into b2, that comes here, okay, and that goes to the OR gate of a less than b and so on. Okay, so whatever equations we have derived in the last slide, that is what we have implemented here, and thus we have implemented the magnitude comparator.